Hello friends, myself Pawan Kadam, Assistant Professor, Department of Chemistry, Sri Venkatesh Arts Commerce and Science College, Virugara. Friends, today we will see the topic chromatography. So, what is the chromatography and we have to learn about it. Now, first we will see the history. So, the chromatography in 1906. It was the first to develop the chromatography to separate the plant pigments. He produced a colorful separation of plant pigments using the color. Now you can observe here the invention of chromatography by the Pitt. So he placed calcium carbonate in the burette and over it add the chlorophyll pigments and a solvent is there. And after that the you can observe here the colors are there, the pigments, they are separated. Now we will see the word chromatography. It comes from the Greek word chroma means color and graphic means to write. So the chromatography means to write with the color. So you can observe here these are the chlorophyll pigments or the pigments in the plants which are separated by using the chromatography technique. So the 12 Nobel Prizes were awarded between 1937 to 1972 for the work in the chromatography. Chromatography has application in the various branches of chemical and biological sciences. Now first introduction. So the chromatography is a physical method of separation. The components to be separated are distributed between the two phases. One is stationary phase and other is mobile phase. Now you can observe here in this diagram the stationary phase is there and the mobile phase. Stationary phase is only one position and the mobile phase it moves. Now in this diagram you can observe here the mobile phase it moves from upward to the downward direction and the samples are present. The stationary phase does not move. The compound in the mixture are attracted to it, that are they are absorbed on the stationary phase and slowed down. The stationary phase may be the solid or liquid. The mobile phase, this phase moves through the stationary phase. The more soluble compounds in the mixture are carried faster as the mobile phase moves. The mobile phase may be the liquid or gaseous. The chromatographic process occurs due to the difference in the distribution constant of the individual sample components. It is a technique used to separate and identify the components of a mixture. It works by allowing the molecules present in the mixture to distribute themselves between the stationary and mobile media. Now you can see here in this video how the chromatographic technique works. The stationary phase is present and in that stationary phase we will put a mixture of compound. So when we add the mixture of compounds in the stationary phase, that is from the one side, and after putting the mixture then we will allow the mobile phase to pass through that stationary phase. So depending on the distribution coefficient of the mixture they will get separated out in the stationary phase and they will move with the mobile phase, and so we can easily separate these mixture components from the mixture. Now we will see the classifications of the chromatography. So chromatography on the basis of phases involved in the chromatography technique can be classified as follows. So the stationary phase solid, mobile phase is liquid, then the type of chromatography is absorption chromatography, and or it is also called as ion exchange chromatography. Next, the stationary phase is solid and the mobile phase is gas. It is called as a gas solid chromatography. Next, the stationary phase is liquid and a mobile phase is also liquid. Then it is called as a partition chromatography, thin layer chromatography or the paper chromatography. Next, the stationary phase is liquid and the mobile phase is gas. Then it is called as a gas liquid chromatography, that is GLC. Classification according to the packing of the stationary phases. Now here that is a thin layer chromatography. In the thin layer chromatography, the stationary phase is a thin layer supported on a glass, plastic or the aluminium plates. Next, paper chromatography. stationary phase is a thin film of a liquid supported on an inert surface. That is, the paper is used in the paper chromatography. Next is column chromatography. The stationary phase is packed in a glass column. Now, the classification according to the force of separation. So, first is adsorption chromatography. Second is the partition chromatography. Third is ion exchange chromatography. Next is gel filtration chromatography. And last is affinity chromatography. So, all these types are depending on the separation force. Now, this is the general types of chromatography you can observe here. That is paper chromatography, thin layer chromatography, column chromatography, glass chromatography, and HPLC. So, these are the commonly used types of chromatography. Now, we will see one by one. That is first thin layer chromatography. It is a method for identifying the substances and testing the purity of compounds. So, in this, you can observe here the TLC plate is present and the mobile phase, that is the liquid, and on the TLC plate, the spots are given and that spots are developing, and it is a TLC chamber. The stationary phase is a thin layer of absorbent. It is generally the silica gel or the alumina coated on the plate. The mobile phase is a developing liquid which travels up the stationary phase carrying the samples with it. And the components of the samples will separate on the stationary phase according to how much they absorb on the stationary phase versus how much they dissolve in the mobile phase. Now we can observe here that is the solvent is present with the TLC chamber. Now we put the TLC plate. Next, that is the TLC plate. Next, we will give the spots of three different compounds, and when they will allow to flow the liquid, the spots will be flow depending on their adsorption and the solubility in the solvent. So the solvent, the spot which is in the lowest position, it is a less soluble in the solvent. The spot which is in the upper direction, it is a more soluble in the solvent, and the spot which is intermediate, it is a not very much soluble, not very much insoluble. So these are the spot developed depending on their solubility in the solvents. So that is TLC is useful technique because it is a relatively quick and it requires a very small quantity of materials. Now we will see the paper chromatography. So in this method, a special type of filter paper is used to separate the component of the mixture. In the paper chromatography, both mobile phase and stationary phases are liquids. The stationary phase is a water supported on the cellulose fibers of filter paper. Thus, it is a liquid-liquid chromatography. So, in the paper chromatography, you can observe that the filter papers are used, and these filter papers, they have the cellulose, that are water is absorbed on the cellulose, and therefore it is called as the stationary phase is liquid, and the solvent which is flowing, that is also the liquid, so it is called as a liquid-liquid chromatography. And depending on the spots are developed, the least polar, the solvent is most polar, so there is a difference in the water. Now, requirements for the paper chromatography. So first, we require the filter paper, what is the quality of the filter paper or the requirements of the filter paper, maximum degree and clarity of separation and negligible of the spots. It should have the excellent rate of movement of solvent front. Then normally Wattmann filter paper number 1 is used. Next, nature of developing solvents. So the solvent must give the circular spots and not tailing should occur. It must be chemically inert towards the component to be separated. It should not interfere in the detection of the components after the development of the chromatogram, and it should not be too viscous. So the solvents generally used for the chromatographic separation. Now the steps involved in the paper chromatography. First step, that is the sample preparation and application. So a strip of the filter paper is taken and a horizontal line is drawn with a pencil 2 to 3 cm above one end. Prepare a concentrated solution of the sample by dissolving it in a suitable solvent. Next step, the sample spot is applied in the center of the horizontal baseline. The short spot should not be too small or too large. You can see here that is a paper strip is present, and we have drawn a line from the about 2 to 3 cm from the baseline, and the spot is given in the center. The spot should not be very large or very small. So next is developing or running of chromatograph. So take a suitable solvent in a chromatographic tank. Cover the tank so that it becomes saturated with the solvent vapors. Next, suspend the filter paper strip in such a way that the lower end dips in the solvent. So do not dip the spot of the solvent, spot in the solvent. When the solvent rises to a sufficient height, paper is taken out and the solvent front is marked with the pencil, and dry the paper with the air. Now see here, so that is a chromatographic chamber. So it closed with the lid, allowed to saturate the solution, and when we put the paper, the solvent will be rise and there is the solvent front. So mark the solvent front with the pencil. Next, location of the spot. If the spots are colored, they can be easily observed as such. But sometimes the spots are not visible, then we have to use the locating agent. So the locating agent is holding the filter paper in the ultraviolet light, or we can use the locating reagents like rubinic acid, DMG, neem hydride. So we have to spread the paper with the suitable locating reagent so that the spots can be easily visible. So here you can observe that. So the first strip, you can observe the spots just like in the ultraviolet light. Next is spraying the neem hydrin, and next is the KMN4. So the different stains are also used. Now RF value. So what is the RF value? The spots of the separated components are identified from the RF value. The RF value indicates that is the retention factor. RF value is the ratio of distance traveled by the solute from the baseline to the distance traveled by the solvent from the baseline. So the formula for the RF value is distance traveled by the solute from the baseline divided by distance traveled by the solvent from baseline. Now see here one example. In this we can calculate the RF value. So in this compound you can observe there the compound travels from baseline to some specific position, that is 4 cm, and the solvent front it travels 5.5 cm. So what is the RF value of this component? This compound we can calculate by using the formula. So RF, that is a 4, it is the distance traveled by the solute from the baseline. Next, 5.5, it is the distance traveled by the solvent from the baseline. Now the RF value, it will be 0.72. so the RF value depends on the following factor, that is the nature of component, the nature of developing solvent, the nature of quality of paper used, and the temperature. So these are the factors which affect the RF value. Now types of paper chromatograph. The paper, depending on the way in which the chromatograph is run or developed, there are the 4 main types of chromatography. So ascending paper chromatography, in this the movement of the solvent is in the upward ascending direction, that is filter paper and the solvent, and the solvent will be the flow in the ascending direction, in the upward position, that is the solvent moves in the upward direction opposite to the gravitational force. So solvent moves by the capillary action. The speed of the process is slow. Next, descending paper chromatography. So in the descending paper chromatography, a filter paper strip is suspended in the chromatograph chamber and the solvent is present at the top of the chamber, and the solvent flow in the downward direction, that is toward the gravitational force. So in this method, the solvent is kept at the top of the chamber and is allowed to flow down the paper. The liquid is moved by the capillary action as well as gravitational force. The flow is more rapid as compared to ascending chromatography. Now next, circular paper chromatography. So in this, a circular paper is used, filter paper is used, in which in the center the sample spot is given in a circular near to the center, and in the center that is the solvent flow. How the solvent is flow? So in the direction, it is to from the center towards the outward position. So you can observe here, when we put the filter paper on a petri dish, the wick is present, and from the wick the solvent rises in the upward direction and then moves from center to the side of that circular paper. So in this method, a circular filter paper is used. Solvent travels from the center towards the periphery of the circular paper. The wick at the center dips into the solvent in the petri dish, and the solvent rises to the paper and spread along the paper and separates the sample. Now next is the two-dimensional paper chromatography. So this method is used when the components cannot be separated by using the one solvent. So in this method, a square-shaped filter paper is used. The sample spot is given at the one corner of a filter paper and is placed in a chromatographic tank. So a square-like filter paper is used and a spot is given at one corner, and solvent E is used to allow to flow the mixture. The solvent rises along the paper. Some components are separated. Means when the liquid flows in the upward direction, the some components are separated. Now next, now the filter paper is turned in the 90 degree and placed in the another solvent. So the filter paper is rotated and again it is put up in the another solvent, that is solvent B, and again allowed to rise the solvent, and the solvents now, the components now they will get easily separated. So that is the two-dimensional paper chromatography. It is used when the solvents they cannot be separated by using the one solvent. So in this method, the two different solvents are used to separate the components. Thank you.